We were looking for materials that would respond to sound, and we could test that. So I had a former student, he went to take walks in our nature preserve and he saw a spider web blowing in the wind. And so he borrowed a spider from the nature preserve, brought it back, and figured out a way to collect the silk from the spider. And then we tested it in this chamber and measured its response to sound and found it was amazing. The question came up, well, if spider silk responds to sound so well, maybe spiders can use their silk to hear. This particular spider makes this great big web. It's an orb web weaving spider. We knew that the spider silk responds to sound, so maybe the spider could use that silk motion and as it moves in response to sound and hear with the web. So that's kind of where it came from. It came really from a walk in the nature preserve. Junpeng Lai made measurements on a spider web using the laser vibrometer that can measure the motion of the web in response to sound. And they played sound at the web and measured the motion of the web at like 1,000 locations all over it in order to create a picture of how the web actually moves in response to sound.
So we find that this spider web, if you play sound, they can move with the air particle velocity at its maximum efficiency. So now we know that the spider web can capture sound.
In the case of the spider, instead of using neural recordings, we used behavior. So you play a sound and you see a response.
So we play normal incident sound and we played directional sound at 45 degree angle. But if you play sound at an angle, the sound wave actually arrived at the spider web with a phase difference. We are hoping that the spider can pick up that difference and tell the direction. We play sound at it. We use a 200 hertz and 1000 hertz at different sound pressure level. And we found that spider respond to both frequencies.
The spiders actually can hear with the web. And not only that, but they can tell where the sound came from. They orient toward the sound when the sound is coming from a certain direction, which raises all kinds of other questions. You know, understanding exactly what it means to the spider is kind of another question for someone else to answer.
That opens new perspectives for other researchers, especially biologists.